Hello, my dear adorable students. Welcome to Social Studies class. Today I will be discussing chapter number 12 and the name of the chapter is New Delhi. So we know that New Delhi is the capital of India and is a metropolitan city. Okay. So that is chapter number. I'm going to discuss about Delhi. What is there in the Delhi? What are the tourism place in Delhi? Why Delhi is said to be a capital of India? How many languages are used there? And what kind of people stay there? What are the cultures over there? Okay. So all these things I'm going to tell you in this chapter. Okay. This chapter is all about New Delhi. So the chapter number is 12 and the name of the chapter is New Delhi. Chapter number 12. Name of the chapter is New Delhi. So let me begin the chapter now. Delhi, the capital. Yes, of course. We all know that Delhi is the capital of India. Okay. So Delhi is the capital of India. It is situated along the bank of the Yamuna River. So Delhi is situated alongside the bank of the sites of the Yamuna River. Which river? Yamuna River. Delhi is situated near Yamuna River. It is believed that the city of Delhi was first built by the Pandava kingdom. It was called Indraprastha. So it is believed that first Delhi was built by Pandav kingdoms. Okay. There are many kingdoms like Cheras, Cholas, okay, Pandyas. So Pandyas is said to be a Pandav kingdom. Okay. So Pandav kingdom, it is believed in Hindu mythology. Pandav name is from a Hindu mythology. So it is believed that Pandav kingdoms, okay, Pandav kingdoms only built that Delhi, and it was also called Indraprastha. Okay, so Indraprastha. Thousands of years later, Emperor Shahjahan rebuilt the city and called it Shahjahanabad. So after thousands year, after Pandavas, that Pandavas built, Pandavas kingdom built, okay, Delhi, and after that, who rebuilt our kingdom? Delhi, okay? That is Shahjahan, King Shahjahan, Emperor Shahjahan. That is the King Shahjahan, Emperor. And the Delhi city has been rebuilt by Shahjahan, and the name has been given as Shahjahanabad. Okay, so Shahjahanabad. New Delhi, planned by architect Edward Luthiens, was built as the capital of India by the English. So New Delhi was planned by the architect. Architect, those who build the buildings. Okay, designs. Okay, designing things, building designings. Those who see, they are said to be an architect. So New Delhi, the architectures, the buildings, the monuments were planned. The New Delhi architect. Okay, architecture planning. All this done by whom? All this done by Edward Luthiens. Okay. So was built as the capital of India by the English. So by English itself, the capital of India is built by English. Okay. And the architect of the Delhi, the architectures of Delhi, the monuments and the buildings, all these things are designed by the architect Edward Luthiens. So the national capital territory of Delhi, as it is now called, is surrounded by Uttar Pradesh in the east and Haryana on the other three sides. Okay. The National Capital Territory, okay, NCT of Delhi. Okay. The National Capital Territory of Delhi, Delhi is called as National Capital Territory. Okay. So Delhi is one of our union territories. Okay. So National Capital Territory is that NCT. Okay. It has been called. It's surrounded by Uttar Pradesh. The National Capital Territory has been surrounded by Uttar Pradesh in the east and Haryana on the three sides. On the east side, it is Uttar Pradesh, and the other three sides are surrounded by Haryana. In the middle, Delhi, okay. The three main offices of Government of India are located in New Delhi. The main offices of the Government of India, the headquarters, the main head, okay, is located in Delhi, because Delhi is the capital, okay, one of the metropolitan city, and metropolitan means a huge big city and a big and a busy city. And not only that, Delhi is the capital of India, that is why all the important officers are, okay, so all the government of India officers, okay, important officers, head of the officers are located in New Delhi. Now we'll go on the seats of government. The President of India lives in Rashtrapati Bhavan. So, where does the President live? Rashtrapati Bhavan. Where the President lives, that Bangla say to be as Rashtrapati Bhavan. It has many gardens. The most beautiful one is called the Mughal Garden. So, Rashtrapati Bhavan is surrounded by many gardens. Lots of beautiful gardens are there with lots of beautiful flowers, ornamented flowers, different kinds of flowers. Okay. So, beautiful flowers. The Rashtrapati Bhavan is surrounded by its beautiful flowers and beautiful flower gardens. Okay. And is called one of the most important garden is said to be as Mughal Garden. Okay, so this is one of the important garden is said to be as Mughal Garden. There are two office blocks of the Central Secretariat where ministers have their offices. The Prime Minister's office is in the South Block. Okay, so there are two Central Secretariat office, Secretariat where ministers have their offices, okay. The ministers have their offices. The Prime Minister office is located in the South Block, okay. South Block, and other ministers and departments of the Indian government work from buildings around the South Block. So, Prime Minister office is in the South Block, and other government, okay, government works and departments, other department offices are located around the South Block. Okay, the Prime Minister office is in the South Block, but the other ministers of departments of other ministers office and the Indian government workers, their offices are nearby the South Block. Okay, around the South Block, the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha hold their meetings in Parliament House. The lower chamber members and the Rajya Sabha is the upper chambers. Okay, so the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, they hold their meetings at Parliament, where the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, they meet to discuss. Okay, so meet to discuss, and the meetings are arranged in the Parliament House. Okay, where the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha's meetings are taking place in the Parliament House, where the meetings are taking of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, that is said to be a Parliament House. The governments of other countries also have offices in New Delhi. These are known as embassies or high commissions. The government of other countries also have office in our country. Okay, so these offices are said to be as an embassies or a high commissions. Okay, that is ambassadors come and stay. Okay, here the government of other countries, obviously the government from the other countries, they need some suits to contact with our country. Okay, so they have their offices in the Delhi, and that offices are said to be an ambassadors, where ambassadors from the other countries come and stay. Okay, and otherwise it is said to be as high commissions. Okay, the places of interest. Now we move on forward towards the places of interest. Interesting place. What are the interesting place present in Delhi? New Delhi today has the most modern metro system in the world. That is, you have heard about the metro. Okay, metro rail. Okay, so metro rail, that is a local train. You can say metro, metropolitan. Since it is a metro, metropolitan city, so obviously metro will be there. Okay, the train which runs locally. Okay. Metro system in the world, most modern metro system, not a simple metro system, most modern metro system in the world. New Delhi is visited by tourists from all over the world. So New Delhi, many center of attractions, many attractive places are there in New Delhi. That is the reason where tourists visit. Okay, tourists, those who come to other places, okay, to visit different places or interesting places, interesting monuments. Okay, the people who visit from one place to another for a purpose of seeing the places. Okay, so seeing for seeing the places, for enjoying the places. Okay, for to know about the places. Okay, the tourists are the people who come and visit. Okay, The Red Fort and the Jama Masjid made of red sandstone were built by Shah Jahan. The Red Fort and the Jama Masjid, okay, was built by Emperor Shah Jahan, okay. The Emperor Shah Jahan built Red Fort and Jama Masjid, and it is built by sandstone, okay. On 15th August every year, the Prime Minister hoists the national flag at the Red Fort. So, Red Fort, 15th August, okay. On 15th August, our Prime Ministers, every year of 15th August, our Prime Minister hoists the national flag on Red Fort. Okay, Jama Masjid is one of the biggest mosques in India. Other interesting places to visit in Delhi are the Jantar Mantar. So, this is Jantar Mantar is an interesting place to visit. Then, Qutub Minar is also there in Delhi. Then, Humayun's Tomb, okay. Then, Lodi Gardens, India Gate, Rajghat, Shanti Van, Nehru Planetarium, Shankar's International Dolls Museum, the Zoo. All these are the interesting place, interesting monuments, interesting things to visit. Okay, so people come here, the tourists come here to visit all the, I mean, interesting places. Okay, like Jantar Mantar, Nehru Planetarium, then Qutub Minar. All these things are interesting things which is present in Delhi. Okay, so this makes Delhi more, I mean, fascinating, more interesting place. Okay, for the tourist attraction. Delhi is one of the tourist attraction city. Okay. So, Rajghat is the Samadhi of Mahatma Gandhi. Rajghat is the Samadhi of Mahatma Gandhi. You can say as a tomb also. Rajghat is the tomb of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation, the father of our nation, that is Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. We say it as Mahatma Gandhi is the father of our nation. The Amar Jawan Jyoti is a flame lit at India Gate. It burns all the time in the memory of those Indians who sacrificed their lives for the country. Yes, the Amar Jawan Jyoti. So, always flame. The Amar Jawan Jyoti flame is always 24/7, 365 yearly, 24/7, every day. Not even for a single moment, the Amar Jawan Jyoti, switched off or put off. Okay, so it lit. The flame is lit in the India Gate continuously for the memory of, for giving respect to the those people who sacrificed their life for the country, okay, like soldiers, you can say soldiers sacrifice their life for the sake of the citizens of India to save the country from the enemies from the other countries, okay. So for to give them respect and for the memories of them, the Amar Jawan Jyoti flame is lit 24/7, that is 24 hours a week, okay, continuously every day, not even a single moment the Amar Jawan Jyoti flames off, okay. Places of worship. There are a large number of places of worship for all religions in Delhi, okay. So, Delhi is not particularly for a single religion, okay. So, Delhi, there is a places of worship for all religions, okay. So every religions can worship in Delhi, and there is a place also. Let us see the places. Some of these are Akshardham Temple, Birla Mandir, Lotus Temple, Gurudwara Sisaganj, Gurudwara Bangla Sahib, Jama Masjid, and Saint James Church, okay. So Jama Masjid is for Muslim, Birla Mandir, Lotus Temple, Hinduism, they go and pray worship there, and Saint James Church is for Christianity. So all the religious people can go there and worship to their temples, mosque, and masjid, okay. So all religious have equal rights, okay. So everything they have. Delhi is very hot in summer and very cold in winter. Yes, of course, Delhi is very much hot in summer seasons and very much cold in winter seasons, okay. So hot and dry winds called Lu blow in the month of May and June. So in the month of May and June, they get the Lu, that is the mixture of hot and dry winds, okay. It is hot and dry, not the wet one, not fully vaporized one, okay. So hot and dry one, it is mixed together, okay. So that Lu blows in the month of May and June. It rains mostly between July and September. So Delhi, okay, in the month of July and September, it rains in Delhi. Rain comes in Delhi in month of July and September. Then celebration. What are the festivals has been celebrated in Delhi? What are the festivals celebrates? What are the festival is celebrated in Delhi? Okay. So all major Indian festivals are celebrated in Delhi. So all the major Indian festival, okay, celebrated in Delhi. Diwali, Dashera, Durga Puja, Holi, Eid, Muharram, Christmas, Easter, Guru Parva, Buddha Purnima, Mahavir Jayanti, Pongal, Onam, Chhath and Navroz. There is a grand parade on Republic Day. So all these festivals, okay, all the mixtures of festivals, all the festivals like Guru Purava, then Mahavir Jayanti, then Pongal, Onam. Pongal is specially for the South Indian celebration, okay. South Indian celebrate the Pongal. Onam is also South Indian celebrate the Onam, okay. So but still South Indian main festival of South India is Onam, Pongal, all these things. So although it is not the main festival of Delhi, but still it has been celebrated there. Okay, celebrated there all festivals. Okay, all religions can celebrate their festivals in Delhi. Okay, so there is a grand parade. So March, Army March, grand parade on Republic Day. Okay, so like most Indian living in other towns and cities, the men wear trousers and shirts and the women wear saris and salwar suits. Many women and girls wear jeans and skirts too, okay. So normally the people of India, whatever the clothes normally the people of India wear, the same way Delhi people also wears. The men wears trousers, shirts, jeans, pants and all these things, and the women wear salwar suit, saris, and some women, the modern women, some girls wear jeans and skirts too. Okay, in Delhi you can meet people from all the states of our country. They live and work here. They speak different languages and celebrate their own festivals. Thus we can call Delhi a mini India. So in Delhi you can find a mixture of cultures, okay. So different state people, Odia from Odisha, the Odia people come and stay there, from South Tamilian people, that is from South India, from the Northeast India, the Bengalis, West Bengal people, okay. So everyone goes because the Delhi is one of the metropolitan cities, everyone from every state people goes there and stay. So it is a mixture of cultures, okay. There everything has been celebrated, not particularly only the Christian, the Delhi person should go only to the church. It is not like that. Every religion people can go to their respective worship places, okay. So respective worship places, the Hinduism can go to the temple, then Muslims can go for, Islams can go for mosque, and this church, Christianity go to church for the worship, okay. So it is a mixture, okay. It's a mixture of, mixes of people, okay. Stay, the people from all the states come to Delhi and stay. They speak different languages, obviously. So the people from Odisha will speak Odia language, the people from South Indian state will speak a Tamil language, and the people from West Bengal will speak Bengali, and the people from Assam will speak Assamese, okay. That is the people, those who go there and stay, they have their own languages, their own state languages. So there all the languages has been spoken, okay. That is a mixture of languages they can speak there and celebrate their own festivals, okay. Thus we call Delhi a mini India, okay. This is the reason why we call it as a Delhi a mini India, because each and every nook and corner of the people of India, each and every nook corners of the people of India can go there and stay there, and they can celebrate their own festivals, they can speak their own languages, they have their liberty to do, okay. So that is why Delhi is said to be a mini India. Here ends the discussion. If you have any doubt, any question regarding this chapter, you can contact me between 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. to get it clarified with all